Hi, I'm Phil Baker. I'm the president and CEO of Hecla Mining Company. Hecla is the largest silver producer in the United States. In fact, we produce 50% of all the silver that's mined in the country. And we will soon, probably next year, produce 40% of all the silver mined in Canada. And we've been a silver miner for the past 130 years, and we're in our largest growth period of our history. Hecla operates three mines, silver mines. We do also have a gold mine in Quebec, but our key assets are these silver mines. The most prominent one, the foundational asset, is Greens Creek in Alaska. It is the 11th largest silver mine in the world. It's been in operation for 35 years. We have been part of that for the whole 35 years that it's been in operation. We have owned 100% of it since 2008, generated in since that time about $1.3 billion of free cash flow, so a big cash flow generating operation. It also produces zinc, which is a critical mineral, produces lead, and then we also have a gold credit. So it has been a key asset for us. Has a long mine life in front of it. It should be minimum of 10 years, but Greens Creek has operated with 10 plus years of reserves for the last 35 years. Then we have our Lucky Friday mine in Idaho, and it's a mine that's been in operation for 82 years now. It is a unique operation because it's the deepest mine in the United States. The very bottom of the mine is 2 miles below the surface. It's a technical marvel, and maybe later I can talk a little bit about the innovations that we've had there. But this mine has typically in the past produced about 2.5 to 3 million ounces a year. We're on a path of producing 5 to 6 million ounces a year over the next decade. And I think there'll be even growth beyond that. And then our newest silver mine is in the Yukon. We acquired a company called Alexco a year ago. We've been investing in both the mine and the mill. We're now ready to start production. So we'll start this next quarter, the third quarter of this year. And this mine will produce 2.5 million ounces this year, probably 4+ million ounces next year and into the future. And it will ultimately be a very low cost operation and a high cash flow generator for Hecla. In 2012, we became part of the core safety program that the National Mining Association in the United States has. And this is a program that came about because of the recognition that the industry needed to improve its safety record across the board. And so the biggest and most complete sort of safety programs that the largest companies had put together, they basically took that intellectual property and gave it to the rest of the industry. And so we adopted this core safety program, and it's a very rigorous program in order to improve your safety system. As a result of that, since that time, our safety record, the accident record that we have, has improved dramatically. We're, I think, roughly 10 times lower safety incidents today than what we had back in 2012. And it's really as a result of this core safety program. And we put safety as the most important element of our business. At the Lucky Friday, with a new mining method that we actually have removed the seismic risk that miners are subject to. So we have a mine that has had a degree of risk before where the risk is almost eliminated today. We invented a new mining method. We're in the path of getting it patented. It was recognized by the SME, which is the engineering mining organization of the United States. And so we received the innovation award for this new mining method. What this mining method does is essentially allow us to determine when an earthquake happens and where it happens, effectively, is what it does. And so when we blast the ground, We have these very large blasts, and the ground closes in a microsecond after the blast, about 9 inches, and it de-stresses a very large section of the mine and allows us to mine it safely, as I was saying, but also more productively. So we will increase the throughput of that mine about 50% over where we were a year and a half ago. I would expect that you'll see another probably 20 to 30% increase in the productivity of the mine while it's safer. So Hecla, as I mentioned at the outset, these are mines that have been around a long time. And so we become part of the community. We don't particularly have a big community relations program because our people are the ones that are really part of that community. You know, our people are the leaders in the community. They're the umpires in baseball games. They are fully integrated into the community. So that's the number one thing that we do, where we're engaged in the community. And then we provide jobs that are the best paying jobs. We are the largest private employer in every community that we operate in, with the best jobs. And they're long-term jobs. And they're jobs that provide a living wage and also provides security for the future, because we have retirement programs for employees. And then finally, we're in communities often where there's First Nations, Indigenous people, and we have very strong relationships with those people as well. The growth of Hecla is pretty remarkable, what we have had over the last 5 years. We basically have gone from 10 million ounces of silver production to this year we should be at 17. Next year we should be at 20 million ounces of silver production. So doubling in basically the last 6 years. We will at that point reach a plateau. We have projects that we're contemplating that will provide further growth. But that 20 million ounces of silver production makes us probably the fourth or fifth largest silver producer in the world that is focused on silver. The thing I'd like them to know is we have these long-lived, low-cost assets that are located in the best jurisdictions, that have growth, that have security of title, and we're not going to stop there.